It was February of 2012 when the first group gathered here at River Oaks for something we called Run for God. Honestly, I had no idea what to expect. And yet 12 weeks later, we completed the first annual Rock 5K. Much more than that though, for most of us, that experience was life-changing. We brought many reasons for participating, from the need for community, to the desire for spiritual growth, to the anticipation of improving our fitness. And when we all brought those together, we met every Monday night and we joined in that fellowship and we trained and encouraged one another, there were some special things that happened. Well, next week, we begin Run for God 2022, the 11th season of Run for God. These chairs, these tables are going to be filled. The volume of laughter and conversation is going to be as a melody to the ear. And I am excited to share that time with you. And so for those of you who have registered, I want to give you just a couple of minutes of what to expect and how you can come prepared. For those of you who have not yet registered and are just curious, maybe you hang around and watch and give you a little bit better idea of what you might can expect if you were to join us. Either way, the registration is in the description and the comments on this video. Okay, so what you need to know for your first Monday night. Well, first of all, I do want to emphasize that we are theming it, as we tend to do. This year, the theme is growing and training in wisdom, biblical wisdom. So anchored loosely in Proverbs 4, 11, and 12, when you walk and if you run, we want to make sure that we are walking in this world in a way that Scripture would say is wise and not foolish. So each week, we'll have a short study or devotional somewhere in Scripture speaking about godly wisdom, and then even our connection craziness, our chaos that happens around the tables or in this room for all ages will reinforce the idea of wisdom. So that's always a fun time. But beginning Monday, February 21st, 6:15, we are meeting in the community room right here in the Discipleship Center. If you have never visited River Oaks, you just come around the parking lot all the way around the building to the Discipleship Center. Look for the portico driveway. Those are the doors that you'll enter and you can't miss. We're going to be in here. I'll share some information. I'll share with you what the deliverables for Run for God really are, what they are not. I'll give you all the FAQs on administrative processes, registration fees. You don't have to pay Monday night. In fact, I invite you, if you want to participate a couple weeks and see if this is the right season for you, I'll explain what the fee covers. One of the things I'll tell you that it covers is your race fee. Your race fee for the May 14th Rock City Lights Ministry 5K. And so you will not register as normal. I'll explain all that. That also is a good reason why you're doing Run for God as well, because we're all marching together to the City Lights Ministry 5K hosted here at River Oaks, the 11th annual Rock 5K. So you'll want to check out that race registration page, though. There's a lot of information about it, and that might help you prepare. I'll also emphasize, whether you're walking or running, we're going to talk to both groups. As a walker, there are ways that you will train so that on May 14th, you feel good about your walk. That you've improved your endurance and your fitness, and that it's been highly enjoyable. As a runner, even if you don't run now, we're going to trust the plan, and we're going to follow it, and you're going to have a wonderful time completing the Rock 5K on May 14th. Likely, if history is an indicator, in a way that far exceeds your expectations right now. And so we'll talk about the training plan. I'll have the training plan to hand out to everybody. I've got a book to hand out to everybody and talk about everything else, answer those questions. Other than that, please register if you are planning on attending. If you haven't, don't worry about it. Show up. But please register when you can, because it really does help with the waiver and it helps me contact you with information if necessary. I'll also say back to that fee, if that's an obstacle for you right now and you're thinking, I don't know if I can pony that up right now, talk to me. That is never an obstacle to your participating in Run for God. So let me work with you on that. Other than that, hydrate this weekend. No need to carb up yet. We're going to have what we normally have as our beginning Carbapalooza. We're going to have that toward the end of Run for God this year, toward week 11 or 12. So we're still going to have it. But Monday night is week one, and I'm excited. We're going to do, I believe it's 60 seconds run, 90 seconds walk, something like that, eight times. And we're going to do it right here in the parking lot. We have almost a half mile loop now with the additional hardtop of the discipleship center, and we will do that after we have our orientation meeting in here for week one. I really think that's all you need to know. Tell a friend, it's not too late to register. Tell someone you're doing it. Let's let them hold you accountable as well. I pray and I hope that your experience in Run for God 2022 will be as life-changing as it has been for myself and so many others over these past 10 years and now here in year 11. So have a wonderful weekend, and I can't wait to see you on Monday night as we begin this journey together. Blessings, friend.